Dihydroberberine for weight loss. Does this actually work? When I go on Twitter, when I go on YouTube, there's people bashing it and there's people piping it up like it's the greatest thing ever made. What's the truth? What's the studies? Can you really lose belly fat by eating this thing? We're starting now. I see a lot of diabetic patients. One of our clinics is an endocrinology facility where almost every patient is on some type of medication for weight loss. I see all the medications, all the new ones coming out, all the dosages. I've seen 400 pound people drop to 150 pounds. I've seen people where it had no effect. I've seen people that get so bloated and gassy the next day that they have to quit within the first week. What do the studies really show about dihydroberberine? In my opinion, I'm gonna go spoiler alert here. I really like dihydroberberine. The quick background is dihydroberberine is a much better absorbed version of berberine. Berberine is an all-natural molecule that's extremely well studied. It's from tree root barks, it's from turmeric tree bark, and it's kind of removed. And when you eat it, it lowers your blood sugar. It does a whole bunch of other things. But weight loss is the number one most popular benefit. And this is probably why you're watching this video. So does it really work? We're gonna go over the specific studies. But in my opinion, just to get this out of the way, dihydroberberine is converted to berberine and about 2 to 3 times as much gets absorbed into your bloodstream. So you need to take less of it. It actually costs less as a result and is much more beneficial. The first study is dihydroberberine and weight loss. The title of the study is dihydroberberine as a potent modulator of obesity and metabolic syndrome. This was published in the Journal of Clinical Endocrinology and Metabolism in 2018. There were 100 participants. Their BMI was about 28 to 36. Unfortunately, in today's world, people think that's not bad, but technically it's still obese. And you should be much lower than this for all health studies. So 100 people, the duration was 16 weeks, and people took 150 milligrams of dihydroberberine twice daily. So in the morning you take some, and in the evening you take some. Personally, I take it right before 2 large meals, and it stops that blood sugar spike, especially if you're a diabetic. So you wanna be taking that. So 16 weeks, that's 4 months. The weight loss in the dihydroberberine group lost 15.9 pounds in a 16-week period. That is phenomenal. So in 4 months, you lose 16 pounds doing nothing except taking a cheap supplement that probably cost 80 bucks total. If I told you you could lose 16 pounds right now for 80 bucks, would you do it? It's probably a good deal. I'd take that. But again, it's not perfect, and sometimes these studies are a little bit overhyped. The comparison group lost an average of 4.6 pounds. The reality is one type took dihydroberberine, one didn't. They both lost weight, but the dihydroberberine group lost a significant amount more of weight. Again, you know you're taking it, so maybe you change your diet habits. That's the problem with some of these studies. The weight loss in the dihydroberberine group statistically was significant. In measurements, the weight loss, the waist circumference was a lot better. The blood sugar levels were a lot lower, and there was an improvement in blood fatty levels, so the amount of cholesterol in your blood. The reality is no one's gonna pay a lot of money for a low-cost natural supplement, but Big Pharma will pay a lot of money for $1,000 per month medication that they wanna make available to everybody. So study number two, dihydroberberine and insulin sensitivity. So my favorite uses of dihydroberberine are for people with high blood sugar and diabetes, which is related to body fat. The study title is dihydroberberine improves insulin sensitivity and reduces glycemic variability in type 2 diabetes. This was published in the Diabetes Care Journal in 2017, and it looked at 75 adults with type 2 diabetes. For 12 weeks. The dosage was 100 milligrams of dihydroberberine 3 times per day. So same thing as the previous study, 300 milligrams broken up into 2 or 3 dosages. The results after 12 weeks, which is 3 months, showed a 30% improvement in insulin sensitivity. What that means is they had to take their hemoglobin A1C, which is your average blood sugar level over 3 months, decreased by 1.2%, which is huge. That's actually huge, because normally like 6.5 or 6 is pre-diabetic, and that's where you start seeing those symptoms. They say you should be under 6 now, although that number is always changing a little bit. I don't know what it is exactly today or at this time of the video, but it's in that range. The comparison group, the placebo showed no significant levels, so this was compared. 75 patients overall had a significant drop in blood sugar levels. As a result, we know that's related to fat loss as well, and the study showed that as well. Study number 3, dihydroberberine and cardiovascular health. This looked at cardioprotective effects of dihydroberberine in patients with metabolic syndrome. This was published in 2016 in the Journal of Cardiology. There was 90 adults with metabolic syndrome, and the duration was 24 weeks. The dosage was 200 milligrams of dihydroberberine twice daily. So this was a higher dosage, 200 earlier, 200 later. And this was for 24 weeks. So that's a long period of time. That's almost half a year. The results showed a significant reduction in total cholesterol by 18% and LDL cholesterol, which is the bad one, by 20%. The blood pressure also dropped by 10 blood pressure points on average. There was weight loss seen, and in the comparison group showed no significant weight loss and no significant changes in blood markers. This is a clear win for dihydroberberine. Not as potent as taking one of the injectable expensive medications, but the result is clear and it's relatively safe and relatively effective. Study number 4. This one was titled The Anti-Inflammatory and Antioxidant Properties of Dihydroberberine in Chronic Inflammatory Diseases. This was published in the Journal of Inflammation in 2019. 60 adults with chronic inflammatory conditions took dihydroberberine for 12 weeks. This was 150 milligrams of dihydroberberine twice daily, so 300 total milligrams during the day. There was a much lower level of C-reactive protein and interleukin-6. These are both inflammatory markers, 25 and 30%. There was less antioxidant enzyme activity by 35%. That's actually pretty impressive. I gotta start taking more of this stuff. The comparison group showed no significant changes in inflammatory markers or oxidative stress. So again, this is half a year, but you're talking like 20, 30% improvement in your whole body inflammation. That's unbelievable if it's true. And this is a pretty natural thing that they're not selling as a big pharma group. You know, these supplement manufacturers probably don't have the money to pay for these studies, but big pharma does. These studies further show the benefits of dihydroberberine. It has some good evidence in weight loss, insulin sensitivity, cardiovascular health, and I'm gonna cheat in this video. Not really cheat, because I think it's completely fair, but we know that dihydroberberine turns into berberine once it's absorbed through our gut. So essentially, the benefit of dihydroberberine versus berberine is you can take much less, like 50% less, of the dihydroberberine and get double the effect of berberine. So all the bigger studies over time of berberine, we can also count as dihydroberberine. I want to show you the specific dihydroberberine, but I think the berberine studies are even greater because we've known about berberine much longer than dihydroberberine. But now we have dihydroberberine. It's easier to make as a supplement. The cost is lower because you can take less of it. How much berberine per day? The appropriate daily dosage of dihydroberberine can vary depending on the individual health goals, but specifically most people watch this for weight loss and lowering blood sugar levels. All the studies that I have seen take about 100 or 150 or 200 milligrams once or twice per day. So almost all the studies I looked at vary between 200 to 300 total dihydroberberine per day. This provides an effective dose to get all the results, such as blood sugar control, insulin sensitivity, weight loss. This is really the way to go. If you want to look at dihydroberberine for weight loss, check out this video on the benefits and recommendations of choosing a dihydroberberine supplement and all the tips and tricks how to use it, including the proper dosages. Check that out right here.